Hello guys, it's me, Carlos Santos, aka Happy Carlos 95, and welcome to another edition of NASCAR E5 Career Mode. So, it's actually Darlington, and as I titled it, Darlington Dynasty. I mean, I got a good handle of the driving a cup car here in Darlington because, yeah, just ride along the wall and make sure you don't hit it too hard because you're gonna have a poor lap time, to be honest. So here's my qualifying lap so you guys see what I'm doing. So let's see if I can roll this thing down to 1 and 2 and get a good launch in the back straightaway. So solid so far, but I don't know what that is not gonna go too well. Looks like we're gonna have to qualify in the bell. Did I intentionally mean to do that? Yeah, we're gonna start dead last anyway. Get the backup car, guys. We're gonna have a long night. So here are the stories of the race. And it says Christopher Bell, John Hunter, Nemechek, and David Reagan, for some unknown reasons. One of them, or all of them, will start in the back. So, well, Christopher Bell's the pole center because he's having a good run. And then John Hunter, Nemechek, and David Reagan, are going to the back. So. I thought David Reagan would have drove out of retirement to run this race, but it is what it is. And 40 cars are here in Darlington. The green flag is out. So, right there with Quinn Half right there. And I, as I know, this is not a racetrack to mess with, so. You gotta keep passing car after car after car to really see how it feels to, you know, get around this place. So I get up to 35th on the first lap. Get around to Chastain for 34. He's one of my rivals here, so it's gonna be hard to pass. Yeah, and he pinned me down there for a reason. I don't know all of my rivals that I've had, but yeah, Ross Chastain was one of them throughout my 3 seasons in NASCAR E5, so. And I think that's Joey Gase right there. Oh man, I dive bombed Bobby Carter. Yep, I think Bobby Carter's mad at me. You're not gonna give up that spot for a reason. So I'll just get to the end of the race. So see you guys later.
room. You're clear. Outside. assistance if you need it. Still there. Clear high, bud. Clear all around. Turn down the inside. All clear. Clear outside.
And I'm back from the beginning of the race, so this is lap 82 of 92. This is gonna be a long few laps, so I don't mind commentating, but I usually don't commentate after like 4 to 6 laps, I believe. And I don't make you guys bored, but I gotta do this commentating so you guys hear my feedback of how I drove this racetrack, so really, yeah, Darlington is a really mean racetrack, the lady in black. So I passed Trace Elliott for 5th right there, and that was a solid pass right there, and and another pass on Joey Logano for 4th. You know why it's called a race team with a dynasty? Because I'm driving the number 40 in Allies Chevrolet. Just replacing Jimmy Johnson for one season. And knowing that this is a legendary ride in which he had lows for most of his career, but Allies stepped in and fill that void, that's all. Oh, I passed Kyle Busch for a second. Yeah, I did. Let's see if I can get Martin Truex Jr. for the lead. Find his weak spot. Drift up the track a little bit. Let's see if I can get him. And I believe I got the lead, so sorry, my voice is a little bit raspy. So there's 6 laps to go. Got the lead, no issues. Most of the competitors' tire wear, they can't match my performance, to be honest. It is, I don't believe it was a total domination win, but hey, it came from the back of the pack, went through my rifle in case they wanted to spin me out on purpose, and really wasn't a big issue. So parts of the videos I did not want to commentate, well, you're gonna get the best part at the end, so. Look at me, scrape the wall a little bit and turn 3 and 4. It's gonna be 4 laps to go, and 4 laps to go means 4 qualifying laps. And as you can see in the bottom left of the screen, I got a big, you know, Martin Drake Jr., which is not gonna be a problem. Just take it cautiously. Take it cautiously, and Everything will be fine. Did you know Clayton Hughes moved to Michael McDowell's team within the past day or so? So, MTJ is sure gonna miss his favorite spotter. I mean, that's one of the reasons that they gotta let him go. Try something different, that's all. And the reason I'm talking about it is because MTJ's second, and you know, whenever MTJ has a spotter that says stage win number X amount of laps, or stage one and two, it's like, oh, you probably understand what you mean by, oh, you let a lot of laps here and there, and that's what you get. And you lead a lot of laps, that's all. So here's a white flag from Darlington Raceway for the Southern 500. I got a huge lead and not gonna relinquish it. So here are the lap cars right here. Am I gonna pass one of them? Maybe I will. That's Chad Fenton I'm passing, and Austin Dillon and Brennan Gunn right there. And I'm gonna win the Southern 500 in my last start. And as I recorded in the past few videos, this will be my final NASCAR season. And as I plan to retire and just run F1, Tony Stewart's All-American Racing Series, and a lot more. And possibly Dirt 4 and the Crew 2 video games series I'll do after this. So I haven't lost my focus, you know, and that's really what I need to do well, that's all. So I make a happy COVID-95, and y'all have a great day, and peace out. So we're coming to the end of my YouTube video right now, so clicking that thumbs up button if you like the video so much. Click on that bell button to subscribe for more content. And if you have any thoughts or feelings about the most recent YouTube video you just saw, share a comment right below the description so I can share some thoughts and feelings with others in the community and make them feel welcome. So I'm AKA Happy Corona 957. Y'all have a great day and peace out.